So a very good afternoon to all of you. So today we were supposed to discuss on the topic of antimicrobial agents and their classification. So today we are the topic what we are supposed to going to cover, it is given the layout. So the first we will look into it, that what are the antimicrobial drugs are and what are the classification of antimicrobial drugs. Then we will come into the antibacterial drugs, their classification, the indications and the side effects. And later on we will also study about the antibacterial resistance that is gained during the time frame by different microbes. So antimicrobial agents or antimicrobial drugs, so as we know that these are the natural or synthetic agents which can kill or inhibit the growth of microorganisms. So these are called antimicrobial drugs. So antimicrobial drugs must have some kind of properties prior of its selection for a particular purpose. So what are the properties? What should be the properties of antimicrobial drugs? So antimicrobial drugs, as we know that these are naturally obtained and synthetic drugs, this must have the property of killing or inhibition of microorganisms. An antimicrobial drug must have a therapeutic efficacy. It must treat the disease or it must kill the microbes without having any bad impact on the host, or minimum or no impact on the recipient. Then it must be cured by providing a very low concentration of dose. So there must be these properties of antimicrobial drugs that must be there. Okay, so if we come to the antimicrobial drugs, so as we know that these are the chemotherapeutic drugs and they are classified into two categories based on their processing or based on their finding in nature. So antibiotics, antimicrobial drugs produced by microorganisms. So basically, when we discuss about the antibiotics, these are the drugs that is produced by one microorganisms and kills or inhibit the growth of other microorganisms are antibiotics. And synthetic drugs are these antimicrobial drugs that are synthesized in a particular lab. Then what should be the ideal characteristics of antimicrobial drug? An antimicrobial drug must have highly selective toxicity to the pathogenic microorganisms without harming a host. Second, it must have or least toxicity to the host. Least means less toxic. Then it must have low propensity for development of resistance, as some of the microbes, they gain resistance with the time frame with a particular drug. So there must be a low propensity for the development of resistance among microbes. Then fourth one, it should not induce any hypersensitive reaction within the host when it is administered. Next, it should have rapid and extensive tissue distribution. It should be free of interactions with other drugs. When different drugs are given to a host simultaneously, then it must be relatively inexpensive. With special reference to aquaculture, where fish species or farmers are very much susceptible to the cost-benefit ratio. Then, where do antibiotics comes from? From where antibiotics we got? So there are several species of fungi, including penicillium and cephalosporin, as you know, and as you have heard. So on the basis of this fungal species, there are the antibiotics which is named after penicillin and cephalosporin as well. हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल राइट नाउ?
आपको फोटो आ रहा है सर?
ओके,
स्क्रीन है।
ओके सो लाइकवाइज द फंजाई, देयर आर सेवरल स्पीसीज ऑफ बैक्टीरिया एज वेल, like actinomycetes, gram-positive filamentous bacteria. These actinomycetes are gram-positive filamentous bacteria. And there are various species of this species from which the streptomyces, like streptomyces graecius, the first antibiotic streptomycin has been derived from there. So also from bacillus, gram-positive spore formers. Then a few from myxobacteria, gram-negative bacteria. Now, beyond these microbes, there are some antibiotics that are explored from plants and fish. Even there are certain fishes are there. From their toxins, we generate some kind of synthetic drugs. And from plants, we also synthesize some drugs or antibiotics from them. So here I have listed a few of the antibiotics that has been derived, that is being derived from different species like Penicillium chrysogenum, Penicillium graeciofluvin, then cephalosporium, bacteria like Bacillus lichenoformis, Bacillus polymyxa, and so on. So you can go through with the slides and you will come to know there are several species from which we can derive these antibiotics. Then in the past days, we have also discussed about the history of antimicrobial therapy. So for the purpose of revision, we just go through that what are the history, what was the major milestone in the field of antimicrobial therapy. So as we know that Paul Ehrlich, who self-claimed as a first first therapy, chemotherapeutic. He self-proclaimed himself as a first chemotherapist. And he turned the coin, he coined the term chemotherapy. Then in 1929, the penicillin discovered by Alexander Fleming. When in 1929, and it was a very accidental discovery, and thanks to work by Alexander Fleming, who found that mold contaminating culture plates with clearing of Staphylococcus aureus. And Fleming then isolated these colonies, these penicillin from the mold. Okay, so actually he went on the leaf, and when he came, then he saw that one plate which was uncovered, and the plate was already inoculated with the Staphylococcus aureus, was having a free zones, and there was some kind of mold growth within that petri plates. So then he worked on it, and he isolated penicillin from them. And when he just cross-checked that particular species in a particular agar plate, then he saw that these Penicillium notatum, which was the species of, which was the species of fungi, is able to inhibit the growth of Staphylococcus aureus. And when Second World War begins, and there was a huge use of this penicillin. When Florey and Chain has produced mass production of penicillin after this doomsday, means World War, after the declaration of World War, and many injured soldiers was treated by this penicillin, and it becomes available to public. So this drug was called wonder drugs. Wonder drugs, why? So because of burning sensation, तो जितने भी आदमी, जितने भी soldiers जल जाते थे या गोलियां लग जाती थी, तो as we know that staphylococcus are residing within our skin hides, onto our skin hides. So they are the very opportunistic pathogens. ठीक है? और होता क्या है? जब primary barrier breach होता है, they can proliferate. They can form boils and pus forming. They cause pus. They cause wounds. So that is being treated with the help of this penicillin and named as a wonder drugs. But prior to penicillin named as a wonder drug, it was the sulfur drug in 1935, which was called at that time as a protonsil and was discovered by Gerhard Domack. Okay, so this protonsil was used for several medication purpose. So in 1929, penicillin was discovered, but the mass production of penicillin as a chemotherapeutic agent was occurred in 1940. And in 1943, streptomycin discovered by Waxman from Streptomyces griseus. So Waxman also having a very good contribution in the field of antibiotic development, and more than 20 antibiotics he has developed alone, along with his team. And the term antibiotic was given by this person, the Waxman, Selman Waxman. Okay. So, what is the classification of antimicrobial agent? How can we classify? So an antimicrobial agent can be classified in a very different ways according to their chemical structure, according to type of organisms to be killed or targeted, or according to the antimicrobial agent they are derived from. So based on chemical nature, these are grouped into sulfonamide, B-lactam, tetracycline, aminoglycoside, macrolide, polypeptide, glycopeptide, quinolones, azole derivative, nitroimidazole. So this is the main group of antibiotics or antibacterial drug which is being used for the treatment of different diseases or disease causative agents. So the example of sulfonamides are given here. You can go through with the slides and you will come to know that there are ample antibiotics whatever you use on daily basis whenever you fall ill and you use it, like sulfadiazine, penicillin, oxytetracycline, streptomycin, erythromycin, polymyxin, vancomycin, ciprofloxacin, then metronidazole. So these are the common antibiotics that you have heard within your lifetime. So antimicrobial. So antimicrobial means it must have the properties to kill or inhibit the microbes. And what are the microbes? It may be bacteria, it may be virus, it may be fungus, it may be protozoa or any helminths. So any antiviral, antifungal, antihelminthic, antiprotozoal or antibacterial agents are cumulative called as antimicrobial agent. Then what is the antibacterial drugs? So antibacterial drugs are the drugs which are active against bacteria only. These are, or these may be natural or synthetic, naturally obtained from microorganisms which suppress the growth or kill other microorganisms, are antibacterial or antibiotics. Then synthetics are made in lab by bioengineering, and the term antibiotic was first used by Sell and Waxman. Now these antibacterial drugs are classified into on three bases. Even though there are various classification techniques on which we can classify this, but mainly the classification of antibacterial drugs are classified on the basis of their spectrum of activity, their type of action, and the mechanism of action. So what is the type of action? It mean to say that whether they act statically or cidally, means they having the properties of bacteriostatic or bactericidal. There are certain drugs like sulfonamides, tetracycline group, chloramphenicol, and macrolides. So these are the drugs, these are the antibiotics which are bacteriostatic in nature. But penicillin, aminoglycoside, cephalosporins, vancomycin, these are the bactericidal drugs, as they kill the bacteria. Not only they inhibit the growth, but they kill the bacteria. So on the basis of the spectrum of activity, the antibiotics are classified into a broad spectrum and a narrow spectrum. When we say about the broad spectrum, means the coverage of these antibiotics are much higher than that of a particular group of microbes like gram positive. Suppose an antibiotic having the properties to inhibit the growth of gram-positive microbe or gram-positive bacteria. So this will be narrow. This is a narrow spectrum. Gram-positive bacteria, even a single species will be killed. Then will be narrow spectrum. Broad spectrum means they will kill, even they are very much selective to the gram-positive bacteria. But apart from this gram-positive bacteria, they are liable to kill some of the gram-negative bacteria too. So these such kind of antibiotics are also called broad spectrum antibiotics. So broad spectrum antibiotics like tetracycline, chloramphenicol, and cephalosporins. And even in daily uses, we also
take Chandan ko boliye mic band kar lene.
Chandan, okay, just I am controlling it. Okay.
Chandan ka sun gaya bhai.
Okay. Now it is muted by me. So the spectrum of activity. So again, one voice is coming. So spectrum of activity. Then there are two kinds of on the basis of spectrum of activity, the antibiotics are classified into two: broad spectrum, narrow spectrum. Broad spectrum: tetracycline, chloramphenicol, and cephalosporin. Then narrow spectrum like penicillin G, streptomycin, erythromycin. After that, on the basis of the mechanism of action, an antibiotics can be classified into several ways. Like some antibiotics, they inhibit the cell wall synthesis. So the bacteria which having the cell wall only get killed. Second class is those antibiotics which cause leakage from cell membranes, means they cause pores into the cell membranes and cell lysis may occur. Third one is they inhibit the protein synthesis by different pathways. Fourth one is they inhibit the DNA gyrase. So where is the DNA gyrase? DNA gyrase in an enzyme that found within a bacteria and participates in what? They participates in the relieving tension from the unwinding of DNA when helicase takes part into replication, okay, or uncoiling of DNA. Then fifth one is they act on the anti-metabolites. So here we can see that this is the bacteria in your mobile screen. You can check your mobile screen. So you can see here there are five kinds of action which an antibiotic show. What? The first is inhibition of cell wall synthesis. The examples are like penicillin, bacitracin, cephalosporin, vancomycin. So where they act? They act on cell wall. Okay. They act on cell wall. They act on glycopeptide linkages. We will see in details in upcoming slides. Then another group of antibiotics, what they do? They disrupt the cell membrane function. Example, polymyxin. So this is the bacterial membrane and this is the cell wall. Then third group of antibiotics, they inhibit the protein synthesis. Some of the examples are tetracycline. The commercial name of tetracycline are teramycin, as you know it. Or even if you are not knowing it, you must know the trade name of tetracycline is teramycin. Then erythromycin, streptomycin, chloramphenicol. So these are the protein inhibitors. So they inhibit the protein synthesis. So once the protein synthesis will be inhibited, bacteria get killed. with a span of time. Then fourth one is inhibition of nucleic acid synthesis. So what they do? They stop replication by different pathways, by different means, like they inhibit the DNA gyrase. They disturb the function of DNA gyrase. Okay. And I hope that all of you have knowing the function of gyrase, helicase, and whatever. So if not, please go through it. Otherwise, we will discuss it in details if our class finishes with the time. Or otherwise, we can discuss it into the discussion classes. So next, action as anti-metabolites. So there are certain metabolites which interferes with the metabolic activity of bacteria, like para-aminobenzoic acid. So this is called as PABA. There are some example like sulfonilamide, trimethoprim. So these are the antibiotics which act as a anti-metabolites. So when we come onto the first mode of action, so the first mode of action was the inhibition of cell wall synthesis. So how they act, how they function, what is the mode of action of these antibiotics? So these are the drugs that interfere with the cell wall synthesis process. These drug consists beta lactam rings, so called beta lactam antibiotics. Beta lactam antibiotics. So again, I am repeating it. This is very important. So these are the drugs consist of beta lactam rings, so called beta lactam antibiotics, and these are bactericidal in nature. So how? So these are inhibitor of cell wall synthesis, as we have just discussed right now. So penicillin, cephalosporin, vancomycin. So how penicillin acts on the cell wall? So this was the first antibiotic to be used clinically and obtained from fungus Penicillium notatum, and the structure is beta lactam. So beta lactam is the ring, is responsible for antimicrobial activity, and the properties like antimicrobial spectrum, stability to stomach acid, and susceptibility to bacterial degradative enzymes like beta lactamases depends upon the side chain, and they also differ in structure by the side chain. If we see the general structure of the penicillin, so we can find here, this is the simpler structure, you can check it. So what is this RHN? It's acyl amino side chain. Okay, this is CHCHCN. Even if you say HNO, so they form beta lactam ring. So you see here, this is the complex structure, this is the simpler structure that is opened further. So this is the coiled one, this is the coiled one, and this one is the simpler structure. So where penicillin acts? So penicillin acts on the site of this beta lactam ring. So site of penicillinase action, breakage of the beta lactam ring. Okay, so then you can see here the structure is thiazolidine ring. Here you can found it carboxylic acid side chain and beta lactam ring, as we have discussed right now. So if we see the working mode of penicillin, so penicillin, how it acts? So penicillin binds to penicillin binding protein. Penicillin binds to penicillin binding protein that found within the bacterial cell wall. Okay, once they bind to the पेनिसिलिन बाइंडिंग प्रोटीन दे इनहिबिट द क्रॉस लिंकेज ऑफ एन एसिटाइल ग्लूकोसामाइन एंड एन एसिटाइल म्यूरामिक एसिड. दैट इज हम लोग बोलते हैं ना बीटा 1,4 लिंकेज. द बैक्टीरियल सेल वॉल इज मेड अप ऑफ टू पेप्टाइड चेन्स दैट इज नाग एंड नाम दैट इज लिंक्ड विथ बीटा 1,4 लिंकेज. और क्या होता है दीज ब्लॉकेज ऑफ पेप्टिडोग्लाइकन सिंथेसिस. ठीक है, अब ये जो यहां पे आप नाग और नाम का स्ट्रक्चर देख रहे हो बीटा 1,4 लिंकेज को ये क्या करता है ब्रेक कर देता है कट कर देता है. और जैसे ही कट करेगा क्या होगा सेल वॉल सिंथेसिस विल बी इनहिबिटेड. पेप्टाइड साइड चेन्स आर क्रॉस लिंक्ड एज द फाइनल स्टेप इन सिंथेसिस ऑफ पेप्टिडोग्लाइकन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पेनिसिलिन. क्या बोल रहा है कि पेप्टाइड के जो साइड चेन होते हैं यानी नाग और नाम के आर क्रॉस लिंक्ड एज द फाइनल स्टेप इन सिंथेसिस ऑफ पेप्टिडोग्लाइकन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पेनिसिलिन बाइंडिंग प्रोटीन. एंड दीज पेनिसिलिन ड्रग्स देन इनहिबिट्स दिस प्रोसेस आफ्टर बाइंडिंग विथ PBPs. जैसे ही पेनिसिलिन ये पेनिसिलिन बाइंडिंग प्रोटीन के साथ बाइंड किया तो ये क्या करेगा ये साइड चेन क्रॉस लिंकेज को